بسم الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الملك الواحد الأحد الغفور الرحيم ذو العرش الكريم الخالق البارئ المصور الغفار الوهاب الرزاق الفتاح العليم سبحانه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد بن عبد الله رسول الله وخاتم الأنبياء نشهدك يا ربنا بأنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد فيك خير الجهاد وحق الجهاد حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله الأنقياء وصحابته الأوفياء ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم اللقاء ونحن معهم وفيهم برحمتك يا رب العالمين برحمتك يا رب العالمين آمين آمين آمين. Today is Friday, so I advise and I invite you to make as much as you can of a salah الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. There is no limit for that druze of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. There is no limit. The sky is the limit. Why don't you try to be the fairest one today, number one, on saying Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi sallam. If it's half day today, so from next Friday inshallah, be number one. From Fajr time, start Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So you try to be number one around the globe, saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, now the second week after Ramadan, and I believe we come out from Ramadan with full iman in our hearts. We've been practicing a lot of good deeds, nighttime praying in the masajid, sadaqat. So that will have a good impact in your heart, and the iman should be very high, very high. But some of us is being diving into the dunya. Very quick, very quick. As soon as the shayateen be released, dunya coming into his mind. And we can't say like dunya is not there for us. No, it's for us. But it shouldn't the Muslim, he cannot having the dunya and the deen in one heart. You have the deen in your heart and the dunya in your hand. So using the dunya to drive you away from the masajid, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the dunya to drive you away from visiting your relatives, dunya driving you away from standing up night time for a prayer, dunya driving you away from being nice to your family, friends. Well, what is it dunya? I tell you, what is dunya? The dunya, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, you go to the sea or the ocean, and you this finger of yours, yeah? You put it in that water, in the sea, and see what you come up with. What you come up with? One drop, two drops. So that's a dunya. That's a dunya compared to the akhirah. Compared to the akhirah. So what's this dunya we are all fighting each other for it? What's this dunya? It is just like that. Two drops or one drop compared to the akhirah. The ocean is the akhirah. The sea is the akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us in the book, the Quran, Al-Akhirah, I think they said it 115 times been called. 115 times Al-Akhirah. And then how we get to the Akhirah? We have to go through something called death. The death. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. You will come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what actually, that this is the key point of how we're forgetting the akhirah. And we dive into the dunya, the way we are now. Because we forgot that we are going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We think there is a no judgment day. This judgment day for people died. But for us, no, there isn't anything like that. And this is quite wrong information you have in your brain. Our brain, sorry. We are dying. And we have to remember this. In a very difficult day, very, very tough day we will face, we all going to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with no translator in between us, no interpreter. No. Allah will ask you what you done in your life. What you done in your life. Did you have the answer? I've been busy in the dunya. I've been busy. You know, the ibadah is Allah. Allah is Ya Allah. You know, amal is ibadah. So I'm working like from 6 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock in the evening. So I can't wake up for Fajr. Even I can't do nighttime prayers because you're so busy. And you know, one dirham you spend on your family, that's the best dirham ever. That's the best dirham ever. The dirham or the pound you spend in your family. We all know all this hadith, all, you know, no? But we don't know the hadith about nighttime prayer. We don't know the hadith of visiting relatives. We don't know the hadith of being good to your parents. We don't know the other hadiths of helping people, be eager to help other people. We have to get this idea right in our hand, on our brain. Like the day of the judgment is called Yawm al-Hasra. Ya Al-Tafillah. Al-Hasra, the day of sorrow, the day of heartbreaking. Our hearts will be breaking that day. Because, I should have done this 2 rak'ahs. I should have do this tasbih in the masjid. I should have come to the Fajr prayer. Rak'atay al-Fajr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, better than the whole dunya. The 2 sunnah before the Fajr time. Then you leave this and you go dive on that dunya. In kan taswa jinaha ba'udha. Masak Allah biha kafir sharbata ma. Jinah ba'udha, the wing of a mosquito. We all fighting on this, a wing of a mosquito. Subhanallah. Not even that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walking in the market. You know the market, I call it like the auction of the shaitan. He got very good deals there, you know, very easy. Shaitan. Alayhim Allah ma yastahiq. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walking in the market with his companions. And he saw a goat, a dead goat, with no ear. Jifa. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, who will buy this by 1 dirham? Who will buy this by one pound? This is Rasulullah. How come we buy this a dead goat? Where is the pound? It's okay. Who can take it for free? One of the companions said, Rasulullah, if he's alive, it's no good. He got some problems, this goat. So we don't want it. Then he say, in Allah's eyes, the world, this dunya, in Allah's eyes, less than what you see this dead goat. What's the dunya for? Less than that dead goat in Allah's eyes. We need to prepare yourself. You know, all these calculations or fighting around the dunya for who will be the boss, who will be the number one in work, who will be number one. This all is down to 3 questions. The first question, when you die, I say, Man Rabbuk. Who's your Lord? Who's your Allah? Who you worship? Man Rabbuk. Ma Deenuk. What's your religion? What's your religion? من هذا الرجل الذي بعث إليكم؟ من الرجل الذي بعث إليكم؟ We should be ready for these three questions. You have to work hard for to be answered this question so easy. So easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi, والإسلام ديني والرجل هو محمد 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 three times. He should be the first person coming to your brain. Who is that man? If I ask you, who is that man? You say Muhammad. He should be number one in your life. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we should be ready for that day. That day you will face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you look at your right is your good deeds and you look at your left are your bad deeds and you look at front is hellfire. Hellfire will be brought that day. It had 70,000 handles, 70,000 zumam, 70,000 zumam. This is Jahannam. Each zumam carried out by 70,000 angels. Ya Atafillah. 70,000 zumam, كل zumam يجره 70,000 ملك. Thus Jahannam will be carried by 4,900,000,000. Is that right? Yeah. 4 billion malak bring Jahannam in front of people to have to cross that Jahannam. أعاذنا الله منا من جميعا منها. That day, يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ يومئذ شأن يغنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. Very busy. There's no time for other people. فاتقوا الله ولو بشق تمرة. اتقوا الله ولو بشق تمرة. اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Even that half of a date, it make a difference for you that time. It make a big difference for you that time. A lady came to with two daughters to Sayyidah Aisha رضي الله عنها. Knocking the door, she's poor. She's hungry. She's hungry. And Sayyidah Aisha, she went to look at her house, the head of the state house, and she found only three dates, three pieces of dates. The head of the state, he got three dates in his house. She can't find anything else. What's the head of the state we have house nowadays? Yeah. What I have of anything? What of his house? Just to be head of anything, how much in your house? Three dates. So she came with three dates, gave this child, the daughter, a date and another date, and she gave them their mom. Then the children, they're very hungry, they ate the dates quicker. And they've been looking at that date and their mom's hands. So the mom puts this one date into two pieces. That's a shiq tamra. That's a shiq tamra, yeah? Half of date. She gave one of her daughter one and the other one. And Sayyidah Aisha said, if you're so hungry, you gave. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, today I've seen something, big mercy. So what? So then our lady came, she told him the story. And he told her, that hungry, and she gave half of a day to each one. Allah gave mercy to this lady by that action, forgive her sins. Ya Allah, be forgiven that lady. Just by that action. So the good deeds will be like 70,000 angels and each 70,000 handles carrying Jahannam. This 70,000 is, this 70,000 last khutbah I said like there is 70,000 from Ummat Muhammad, they're going to Jannah with no questionnaires, yeah? And then this 70,000 now handle, 70,000 angel, 70,000 angels like making tawaf in Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur in the seven heaven, huh? 70,000, 70 years when you throw something in hellfire goes down 70 years. What's this 70 and 70 is like? You should pick up Salah Rasulullah 70,000 times, probably that you'll be one of those 70,000 people entering paradise without any questionnaire. You do subhanAllah probably 70,000. I'm not sure. Allahu a'lam. You know, but like when you 70,000, it must be something in this figure. You know, say Alhamdulillah, subhanAllah, la ilaha illallah, 70,000 times. What do you have? Your job is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't be diverted and obstructed by something else. Dunya. And you have to focus on this death. Death is coming anytime. This man, he is leaving his house and he died. He didn't come home. And we have this like, well, somebody going somewhere and then he died. He has to come back, he has so many things to do. He didn't come back, he died. Then before his ghusl, his wife, she said, this morning he left the house and he told me, Fulan, if I died, Fulan will make ghusl for me. And Fulan, the other Fulan, he will put me down in my grave. I said, whoa, he knows he's dying today, mashallah, your husband. She said, no. For the last 15 years, every time he leaves the house, he's saying that to me. Every time, last 15 years, when he leaves the house, he tell her that. Somebody, this one will wash me, this one will put me in grave. I've been in Oxford a few days ago for a burial, funeral. And I went to the qabristan. I went to the graveyard. And I just sat down there and I just look at people being passed away before us. Subhanallah, you look at the qabr, you don't know if it's a man or a woman. You don't know if it's tall or short. You don't know if he's a black or a white. You don't know if he's a pious or bad person. You don't know his name. You don't know his position. You don't know nothing about him. Just a qabr. That's what we will be. No names. Ziyarat al-qubur, visiting the graveyards, softening your hearts, as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. You know, it's so important. Every now and then, you visit the qabur, so you look and you see this person we just brought down, he's now like 1.5 meters down and like buried. We left them and we're back now. Facing the truth. Facing the truth. كَمْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ عَدَدَ سِنِينَ قَالُوا لَبِثْنَا يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْدَ يَوْمٍ. How much we left? How much we lived? How much you've been in the dunya? They said like a day or a part of a day. يَوْمًا أَوْ بَعْدَ يَوْمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his book, he said like سَاعَةً مِّن نَهَار. Just a moment of a day. Well, this is the beginning. This is just the beginning of the start of the judgment day. You look to your next one like ura, like naked, like it's just like how much we left? How much we've been there? So just 1 hour. سَاعَةً مِّن نَهَار بَلَاغ. That's we've been told. And you won't get that unless you come back to the Quran. You be closer to the Quran day in, day out. It's not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in 3 hadiths. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه وأرضاه على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this is we heard this in Ramadan a lot. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنب. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنب. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنب. So the 3, if you do the night prayers, if you fast Ramadan, and if you stand for Laylatul Qadr, 3 separate hadiths. How important is that? Iman, belief, and ihtisab. That's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anywhere, if it's not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just forget about it. You won't go nowhere. Nowhere, that's al-ikhlas in al-amal. The sincerity in your work. Iman, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe in the judgment day, believe in the prophets, the books, al-qada wa al-qadr, iman. So we do iman only. That's a condition of that forgiveness. Yeah. The bottom line is forgiveness, isn't it? At how to Allah to forgive you. If you miss that in Ramadan, Hopefully not. May Allah make your Ramadan, inshallah, accepted. But you have the rest of the year. The training you've been doing in Ramadan for the rest of the year. There is a Quran is there. Don't go away from the Quran. You need to read the Quran. You need to understand the Quran. To know how many times the Al-Akhirah been the hereafter been written in the Quran. Or what tells you about the Judgment Day itself. The pictures of the Judgment Day. Is the Shamsu Kuwirat, is the Nujum Kadrat, La Hawla wa La Quwwata Illa Billah. It's if you can see the Judgment Day physically, breathing in the Quran. This Quran, this is a book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, to you. It's not only for Sahaba, no. So don't stay away from the Quran. You need to read the Quran. You have to know the meaning of the Quran. Otherwise, how will you know? Just reading it like the letters and that's it. That's it. But there is nothing in your heart about the Quran. You don't understand the Quran. You don't understand the Quran. And I said that last time, we have a scholar here. He said something very, I went through that and was so beautiful, so beautiful. He said, if you don't know the Arabic, you don't know the Arabic language, but you know, Subhanallah, you know, Al-Jahannam, you know, Al-Jannah, you know, Al-Kafirun, you know, Al-Mujrimun, you know, Al-Muflihun, you know, Al-Salihun. Then when you hear something from that, like this from the Imam, you just say dua, Jahannam, Ya Allah, make me stay away from this. Ya Allah, make a dua for Allah. Jannah, Ya Allah, allow me to enter Jannah. And with that, you concentrate on your prayer. You don't move an inch from your prayer for khushu'. Just follow the Imam and see what he's saying. And this is helping, and helping even people that know Arabic as well. Know Arabic or you don't know Arabic, you follow this. It's so important. In no time you cry. In no time you cry. The Imam won't go two lines and you start to cry because it affects you. The khushu' of that prayer. That's what we need to enter paradise. It's not like just like this, you know. It's not something easy. For to be a doctor, you have to study how long? Why, 20 years or something like that? 25 years. Jannah. You know, study, no hard work, no studies for Jannah. And everything you want easy. There's nothing easy. We've been locked up in our Adam father back, and been locked up again in our mom's tummies, and been locked up again in this dunya. We can't move. We can't go nowhere from this dunya. We will locked up again in all our graves. We'll be locked up again. This is only heaven or hell. There is. If you go, layaz billah, somebody goes hell, that will be locked up as well, or his life, or his indefinite life. The freedom only in Jannah. We are looking for the freedom only in Jannah. Through our lives, there is no freedom but Jannah. And we can't enter it when we only fast is Ramadan, we only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan. It's not on. You can't go around Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't do this. You worship Allah through the year, long year. And Allah put Fridays 52 times a year. 52 times Friday. The best day ever. The best day ever is Friday through the week. There is a time in Friday. Whatever you ask Allah, Allah will give you. There is a moment in Friday. Whatever you ask Allah. This Friday is a very important day. It's just so important day. You just concentrate on ibadat in Friday. The best Fajr is Friday Fajr. Well, I think Qiyasan, so the Dhuhr being changed by Jum'ah, so it was the best Asr, Wallahu A'lam, will be Asr of Friday. So the Friday, whatever you do on Friday has to have a meaning in your life. Whatever you do has to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's all down to that three questions in the grave. Whatever you do good is down to those three questions in the grave. Man Rabbuk, what's your Lord name? What's your deen? And what is the man, what's the name? of the man, man or rajul. Who is he? And look at the question. They tell you, who is this? No, who is that man being sent to you? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it's not like this dunya, the teaching of Allah and His Messenger about this dunya, you find it clearly in Ghazwat Uhud. Ghazwat Uhud. Sahaba, radwanullah alayhim. Sahaba. What about us? It's Sahaba, radwanullah alayhim. When they went against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commandment, against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam orders. What happened? They lost. We lost that war. We lost that battle. Following the dunya, you lose the battle. There is nothing special about us. If themselves, that happened to them. So who was? Who are you? Who is me? You follow the dunya, you lose. Forever. You lose forever. Dunya is not for us. You work hard. No, I don't say like, oh, okay, just stay in the masjid. No. This is not the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You work hard, you earn halal money, you earn halal. Well, the problem is you work hard and you earn halal haram money. So this is double loss. You wasted your time and your money also going to take you to hell. Walayaz billah. But I believe, alhamdulillah, all of us here, we work hard for our living, we work hard for our deen. Our deen, this is the main thing. Wallahi al-azim, if Allah forgive you, that's the best day ever in your life. If Allah forgive you, that's what you need. That's what you, no matter what happened before. Doesn't matter what happened before. Just the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And stay away from haram sins, stay away from sins. The sins has to have coming out from this, like iman in Ramadan and like high level of good deeds every day. So whatever you commit a sin has to have impact in your heart. Oh, what is this? What happened? What happened to me? Yeah. Why I'm committing a sin? Ya Allah, forgive me. Ya Allah, forgive me. So if you get the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the sin come and goes and you're holding so many sins in your shoulders and walking about with it, you just give bad report to your Lord, very bad report. Allah deserve you worship Him. It's not like something, just not something like, He deserves that. You worship Allah because He is Allah. Not because that you want anything, because He is Allah, you deserve to be worshipped. And ask Allah the forgiveness, ask Allah the wealth and the health, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen, أن تدخلنا جنات النعيم رب العالمين اللهم رب العالمين ارحم الراحمين برحمتك ادخلنا جنات النعيم رب العالمين اللهم ارحم الراحمين لا تجعلنا اشقياء يا ارحم الراحمين برحمتك ارحم الراحمين يا اكرم الاكرمين يا رب العالمين اغفر لوالدينا ووالديهم الى منتهى الاسلام وذريتهم الى يوم الدين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات من ابينا ادم الى يوم الدين اللهم اصلحنا واصلح بنا واهدنا واهد بنا وعافنا واعف عنا وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم هذا والله اعلم وجزاكم الله خير بارك الله فيكم.